Hello and welcome to my channel Spark Stenographer. Today I am going to deliver you a shortened dictation from Kailash Chandra magazine volume number 14 and the transcription number 298. So guys, ready for the dictation? 10 seconds, 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, I oblige to the honorable members of this house who took part in the debate for the general support that they have extended to its provisions, except my honorable friend who took quite a different and naturally a surprising line. Now I shall deal with the various points that have been raised by my honorable friends. First of all, I would like to answer my friend for what I can call the highly unsatisfactory attitude that he took. Now, sir, the attitude that he has taken may in one word be stated to be hands off the tribals. We are not prepared to accept this position because the tribal people are Indians and they are citizens of India, and therefore they are entitled to the same rights under the democratic constitution as others. I can understand his suggesting that whatever is the best in their culture ought to be preserved, and that is always the attitude. But subject to the advisability of preserving their culture, I would submit to my honorable friend that it is always advisable to the extent to which it possible to extend the principles of a democratic government to these areas as well. Therefore, sir, I would not accept his dictum at all. What is done in their interest by way of a progressive set up of democratic institutions is unwarrantedly dubbed by him as interference. That is not interference at all. Therefore, I would not accept his contention that we are introducing certain measures which constitute any interference at all. I would point out something to him as also to the other honorable members who suggested that we might go the other way and we should go to the fullest extent so far as this democratic experiment is concerned. Sir, Mr. Sapru also made some observations. I always value his observations because they always show a great and earnest study. But sometimes, sir, there are certain elements that he brings in which make it difficult to follow him completely, because to a certain extent they are either academic or they are impracticable. Subject to this, I always value his points and his observations because they arise out of a vast study of the problems with which the particular question is concerned. Now, sir, I might point out that sometimes it is difficult for those people who are long isolated. On account of this isolation, as I stated in my opening remarks, make a people who have to be gradually told what is in their interest. They are more susceptible to a feeling of suspicion and misgiving than the other sections. We have just opened up our avenues so far as the democratic life is concerned, and that is the reason why I suggested that we propose to hasten but slowly, and therefore certain provisions have been incorporated in this bill. Well, sir, in the light of the peculiar conditions that obtain there, we have to be a bit careful. That was the reason why we could not straightway elect the village authorities, in spite of our desire to go to the fullest extent possible. Therefore, sir, I would like to submit to the honorable members of this house that this is an experiment which we hope will be fully successful, and in the course of the next few years we might come before this house for introducing further amendments on the lines that the honorable members have pointed out. The next question that arose was as to whether the chief commissioner of the state should be believed or should not be believed. I would point out, as one of my honorable friends has stated during the course of the debate, that it is the central government, or rather it is the parliament, that is supreme over all these officers, and therefore these officers, the chief commissioner for example, will not be acting in an entirely unreasonable manner or in an arbitrary manner. I would point out that there is an advisory council which has already been appointed with effect from the 1st November 1956. Some honorable members on the other side wanted to know whether a council of advisors has or has not been appointed. I would point out to them that it has already been appointed by the orders of the government issued on the 21st November 1956, according to which there is a council consisting of 5 advisors, and therefore it is not an arbitrary administration by a chief commissioner who is not accountable to any person at all. So we have to approach the question of interference or otherwise, so far as these officers are concerned, from that particular point of view, viz. That ultimately whatever is done in Manipur is subject to the control and supervision of this honorable house, and therefore I request that no misgivings should be entertained so far as exercise of these powers by the chief commissioner or the deputy commissioner is concerned. Stop.